going to start the new topic, which is the complex variable, dear students. And we are going to have a discussion on this topic. Complex variable is a very good topic and easily scorable topic. The important thing about this topic is that it's easily scorable, because exactly the same, it has the same pattern as differential equation. Means in the differential equation also there is not at all so many variation in the questions. Okay, similarly here also, so you will not get to see here so many variations in the questions. Okay, so definitely it's a easily scorable topic, so you should not miss this topic, because in the GATE 2021 almost in each and every branch the question from complex variable has been asked. Okay, so easily scorable, so that's why you should not miss this one. Okay guys, so it's a easily scorable topic. Now let's see what we will have discussed in the complex variable and what is exactly a complex. So let's start this one. So we will cover the in the complex variable, the first thing, that basics of complex number. Means in that particular thing I will tell you about the introduction of complex number, what exactly a complex number, how to deal with the complex number, what are the forms of complex number, okay, in which form we can convert a complex number. Okay, then after that we can think that we can go for that how to find a polar and rectangular or the Cartesian form of a complex number. Then we will have discussion on the basic question. Exactly this is the segment in which basic question has been asked in the GATE examination only, right? After that the important topic is that analytical function, plus including we will have discussion on the harmonic function also. So we will have discussion on analytical plus harmonic function, dear students, right? And the third thing, which is exactly these two things are exactly of the complex integration form. The first is the basic, second is the analytical and harmonic function, and the third portion is the complex integration, like, right? So this is the form of the complex integration, right? So we will have discussion on this one also. So we will have these three or four segments. So this is the only topic which is exactly easily scorable, and the weightage of this topic will be 1 to 2 marks in the GATE examination. Maximum it covers, most of time it covers 1 mark question. Okay, so let's start with the complex number. Now what is complex number, how to deal with the complex number, and exactly what are the forms of complex number. Let's have discussion. Complex number, as it is clear with its name, okay, let me show you a complex number. Define of complex number, what exactly a complex number, because if you know about the complex number then only you can approach to the complex variable, dear students. If you don't know what is complex number, then you are not able to approach on the complex number, okay, complex variable. So complex number, as we know very well, complex number, it's a number which has two parts, real and imaginary, is it clear? Right, means let me show you, a number with real and imaginary part together is called a complex number. That we know very well. We used to learn this concept since the class 11th or 12th, right? It's a simple thing. How we can approach and how we will show it, this is denoted by, complex number is denoted by Z, and complex function or complex variable is denoted by fxy, right? So Z is equals to x plus iota y, we can write down, okay. Or if you don't want to write in the form of x or y, you can write down Z is equals to a plus iota b. This is your complex number, where a is the real part, dear students, you can write down here, where a is the real part or the real number, where b is the imaginary part or imaginary number. Is it clear? So it's a simple thing to approach that complex number. What exactly a complex number? Complex number is a, it's a number which has two parts, real and imaginary. Okay, let me tell you, dear students, why there is a need of complex numbers. Means why we introduce complex number. Without complex number, is there any difficulty we used to feel? Let me show you. Suppose we have an equation like this, okay, y complex number, why complex number? My second question is why we introduce complex number? So why iota is important, right? So let me tell you, if we have an equation, dear students, suppose an equation we are having x square plus 1 is equals to 0. And someone told you that you have to just differentiate this equation. When you differentiate, the result will be x square is equals to minus 1. It will be x is equals to root of minus 1, right? As we know very well, root of minus 1, we don't know what we can write down as a root of minus 1. So that's why we introduce it as a iota. So that's why it will become x is equals to plus minus iota. That's why iota introduced in the movie of the complex number. Right, that's why the entry of the iota starts in the movie of the complex variable or complex number. You can say this is the importance of iota, because whenever we have those number with the negative sign and square root, we don't know how to approach or how to solve those numbers. So that's why we used to say those number as a iota only, right? So these numbers will be iota. Is it clear? Right, guys? So x is equals to plus minus iota. Done? Okay, so that's why iota introduced. If you want, then I can write down here. That's why iota introduced. Okay? That's why iota introduced in the frame. Okay. So it's a simple thing that we know very well. So exactly the complex number is what a complex number? You can say the complex number is nothing but a number which contains two parts, real and imaginary. Okay. You can say real part and imaginary part, or real number and imaginary number. Okay. Let me tell you more things about this one. Okay. Do we have representation? Okay. I think it's repeated. Nah, it's not. Okay. Done. So let's have discussion about one more thing related to complex numbers and complex variable. How we can approach a complex number? So it is denoted by, as I already told you, z is equals to a plus iota b is a complex number. Yeah, this is the real part that we know very well, and this is the imaginary part again that we know very well. Real part and this is the imaginary part, right? Exactly. So from here, dear students, we can say that any complex number, let me write down two things. Any complex number, it's a basic thing. Okay, I'm just giving you basic introduction. Okay, any complex number means z is equals to a plus iota b. Any complex number means z is equals to a plus iota b is a purely real. Any complex number is said to be purely real. It will purely real when purely real, when the imaginary part is equals to 0, that we know very well. It's only possible when the imaginary part is equals to 0, then your complex number will be purely real only. Yes, exactly, we are getting the thing. Again, any complex number is said to be purely imaginary. How it is purely imaginary and when it is purely imaginary? Any complex number is purely imaginary if the real part is equals to 0. Yes, exactly, you can approach if the real part is equals to 0. Okay. Now, any complex number is imaginary. Any complex number, I am not talking about purely imaginary, I am talking about imaginary. Any complex number is imaginary when the imaginary part is not equals to 0. Imaginary when the imaginary part is not equals to 0. That we know very well. That's why the real number imaginary number together make a number that is called the complex number. Is it clear, guys? Yes. So we can say if b is not equals to 0 means here, this is the b. So if b is not equals to 0, we will say this is an imaginary part. Okay. The always complex number having an imaginary part. If we want to make purely real, then the imaginary part should be 0. If we want to make purely imaginary, then the real part should be 0. Done? Okay, now, so as these things are a simple thing, now let me tell you one more important thing, which is exactly the hero of the movie complex number, which exactly you can say the hero of the movie complex number. Now that is called iota. You should know about the basic knowledge. You should know about the basic thing related to iota. So as I think you know, but let me revise the things about iota. right? Basic knowledge of iota is very, very important. So let me tell you about the basic knowledge of iota. So let's talk about iota. What is iota? As we know very well, this is iota is denoted by square root of minus 1, yes, that is equals to iota, yes, okay. Now what is the value of iota, what it becomes, okay, let's have discussion. When we write down iota is equals to, value of iota is equals to root of minus 1. If you want to write down iota square, it means we have to find the square of this one. So it will be, dear student, iota square will be minus 1, right? When we write down the iota cube, it will be, when we have to write down the iota cube, it will be, dear students, when we multiply here iota, so hence it will be minus iota, right? And when we have to find the iota power 4, you will say, you will say iota power 4 is equals to 1 only. Is it clear? Right? So these four things are basic of iota. After that, we can make so many forms. Means if you want to frame, if you want to find out iota power 5, you can easily approach. Iota power 5 is as similar to the iota only. Right? It is similar to the iota. So you can say this is similar to iota. If you want to find out iota power 6, that is similar to iota square. If you want to find out iota power 7, that is similar to minus iota. And if you want to find out iota power 8, it is similar to 1 only. Is it clear? Okay, so these are the things, dear students, which we can see in the iota. So we should know about this one, because when we approach to the basic questions of iota, these things definitely help you. So what is the first thing? Iota is equal to root minus 1 square minus 1 iota cube minus iota, iota power 4, 1, iota power 5, iota power 6 minus 1, iota power 7 minus iota, and iota power 8, 1. Okay, done. So now, is it clear to everyone? I think it's a simple thing to approach, dear students, now. Okay, let me write down one important thing. One important thing, and you can write down is as a note. You can write down it as a note that any four consecutive powers of iota is equals to zero. Sum of any consecutive four powers is equals to zero. Powers of iota is equals to zero. Means if someone asked you about the find the value of iota plus iota square plus iota cube plus iota power 4, it will be zero. Sum of any four consecutive powers of iota, or we can say sum of any four consecutive powers of iota is always equals to zero, dear students, right? So you should know about this one. We can easily approach this thing. It's a very simple thing to approach. Okay, we can always write down, means iota plus iota square plus iota cube plus iota power 4 is equals to zero. If you want to start with the iota power 2, then iota square cube 4 5 is equals to zero. If you want to go with the, means any consecutive four, if in a continuity, means 4, 5, 6, 7, it will be 0, right? Any 4 consecutive powers of iota will be 0. Okay, guys, now I think it's clear to everyone. Now, if we want to, that we know very well, it's a simple thing to approach. So, a number with real and imaginary part is complex number represented. I will tell you the representation of this one. Complex functions, we will have discussion on this one. So right now we are done with the basic thing, that the basic thing means the what is exactly the complex number, what is iota, how to approach iota, what is the property of iota, and how, now we will have discussion on how we represent a complex number, right? We can represent a complex number, dear students, in two forms. The first is called the polar form, right? Okay, and the second is called the rectangular form. Or the second one is called the rectangular form or the Cartesian form, right? X and Y, that is called the rectangular form or Cartesian form. I will show you that one. So we have only and only two forms to represent iota, or we have only two forms to represent complex number. So Z is equals to X plus iota Y when we have this form, z is equals to x plus iota y. This is called the rectangular form. If we want to write down this in the form of polar form, it will be z into r cos theta plus iota sin theta. I will show you how we can approach. This is called the polar form of complex number, and this is called the Cartesian or the rectangular form. Okay, rectangular form, polar form or Cartesian form. Okay, okay guys, right. Now let me show you about this one, particularly this portion. Let me show you about here. Okay, so as I already told you, z is equals to x plus iota y, we are always having. Okay, yes, if you want to find out mod of z, it will be root of this part and this part only. So square root of this one plus square root of this one. So x square plus y square. So mod of z or the modulus of z, the next part is modulus of complex number or modulus of z, that is called the mod of z, is equals to root of x square plus y square, dear students. Right? So it should be clear to you. So we can approach directly from here. Yes, exactly. This is my complex number in the rectangular form or in the Cartesian form, or you can say it is a Cartesian form. I will tell you what will be the polar form. I will tell you. Okay, so I think it's clear to everyone. This is the rectangular and the rectangular form. Now if you want to write down the conjugate of this one, let me write down conjugate of complex number. First we discussed about the modulus, the second thing is conjugate of complex number. If we want to find out the conjugate of complex number, then we can say, dear students, suppose we have a complex number z is equals to x plus iota y. And if we want to find out the conjugate of this one, it means conjugate of any number, which we learned in the class 11th, that conjugate of any number is nothing but we have to change the sign of the imaginary part. When we just make the opposite sign of the imaginary part, that will be the conjugate only. Right? So if you want to make the conjugate of this one or find the conjugate of this one, it will be z bar is equals to x minus iota y, or you want to write down x plus iota y bar, which is equals to x minus iota y. Right? So this is called the conjugate, my dear students. It is denoted by z bar. You can see here what I write down here, z and bar. Right? So z bar is denoted by the conjugate of a complex number. Okay, done. Now, so the first thing we discuss is modulus. The second thing we discuss the conjugate portion. So modulus and complex. Let me tell you a simple property of conjugate. That suppose if we have z is equals to x plus iota y, and z bar is equals to x minus iota y, and if we want to find out z into z bar, it will be x plus iota y into x minus iota y. Yes, exactly, dear students. So when we approach it, it will be x square minus, as we know very well, this is nothing but a plus b into a minus b, means a square minus b square. When we approach it, it will be x square minus iota y whole square. Yes, exactly. X square will be here only, minus iota square, and y square will be here only. As we already discussed that the iota square is nothing but minus 1, dear students, that we know very well. So we can substitute here at the place of iota square minus 1. Hence it will become x square plus y square. What it will become? X square plus y square. So you can say z into z bar is nothing but x square plus y square. Now what is exactly x square plus y square? Can you tell me, dear students, z plus z bar is nothing but the modulus of z whole square. Because when we find out the mod of z square, the square root will be cancelled out. So it will be mod z square. So you can say z into z bar is equals to mod z square. Z into z bar is nothing but mod z square, dear students. So we can easily approach this property again. Is it clear, everyone? Right? Now let me show you one important thing about this one only. Okay. Yeah. Okay, let me write down two or three more properties. We have two and three more properties of complex number. So let me write down the properties of complex number here. So properties of complex conjugate. Properties of complex conjugate. Okay, these are very small things, dear students. These are very small and the basic thing. So the first thing is that if you have z is equals to x plus y, that we know very well. And z bar is equals to x minus iota y, yes. And if you want to find out z plus z bar, it means if you want to add the complex number and the conjugate of that complex number, then the result will be always, when we add these things, the result will be x plus iota y plus x minus iota y, means iota y will be cancelled out. Hence, it will be twice of x. You can say it is nothing but twice of real part of z. Yes, exactly. So when we add up z plus z bar, it will be always a twice of real part of z, right? Yes, exactly. So if you want to write down it in a simple manner, you can write down z plus z bar is equals to 2 into real part of z. Okay, the first property. Suppose I want to find out here z minus z bar, dear students. So what happened to this one? Let's have discussion here only. Z minus z bar, so it is x plus iota y minus x minus minus plus iota y, x and x will be cancelled out. It will be 2 iota y, yes, exactly. So what we can write down as a 2 iota y is nothing but the twice of imaginary part, twice into iota into imaginary part. So can I write down here that z minus z bar is equals to 2 iota into imaginary part of z, that we know very well. The imaginary part of z is always y and the real part of z is always x, right? So these are the small properties of conjugate. The first one, I think it's clear to everyone, z plus z bar. The second one, z minus z bar. Okay, the third one is, which I already proved exactly, modulus of z square is equals to z into z bar, which I proved here. Okay, modulus of z square is equals to z into z bar. Yeah, so you can write down here, this is the property number third, which we already proved here. Okay, and the value of this one, we can write down x square plus y square. It will be mod z square is equals to z bar. So it will be mod of z square is equals to x square plus y square is equals to z into z bar only, guys. Yes, exactly. We can write down here. So this is the property number 3. We have two more properties of this one. Suppose we have somewhere z1 plus z2 bar. If we have somewhere z1 plus z2 bar, it will be z1 bar plus z2 bar, dear students. Yes, exactly. If we have z1 plus z2 whole bar, it will be z1 bar plus z2 bar. Okay, yes. Let's talk about the next one. If we have z1 into z2 multiplication with the bar. Suppose if we have z1 into z2 bar, so the result will be, dear students, it is z1 bar into z2 bar. We can conclude here, when we add two complex number and together we find the conjugate of those two complex number. When we add two complex numbers and together when we find the conjugate of those numbers, we can always approach it as an individual complex number, conjugate of individual complex number. It means z1 plus z2 whole bar will be z bar plus z2 bar, yes. Similarly, z1 into z2 bar means the product of two complex numbers. When we find the conjugate of product of two complex number, it will be the individual product of two conjugate complex number. So you can say it is z1 bar into z2 bar. Clear, guys? So you can easily identify these two things. You can easily approach. Is it clear, guys? Right. Okay. We have two small properties of this one that's similar to this one only. So we can write here, okay, the property number 6 is that If we have Z1 by Z2 whole bar, the same thing which we applied in the addition, which we applied in the multiplication, again the same thing we can apply in the division also. So let me write down here only the property number 6, Z1 by Z2 bar. It will be Z1 bar divided by Z2 bar, right? It will be Z1 bar divided by Z2 bar, right? And the next property which we are having, that suppose we if we have a Z and with the power, okay, let me write down here, we have Z to the power n, and whose bar if we have to find out, Z to the power n, it can be Z squared, Z cube, Z4, Z5, anything, right? And if we have to find out the conjugate of that one, it will be, dear students, Z to the power bar into n, right? So the things are same. Suppose we have Z square and we have to find out the conjugate of that Z square. So we can go for that one. We can find the conjugate of first Z, then we can find the square also, right? So these two things are similar. Clear, guys? Okay, so I think it's easily approachable to everyone that these are the basic properties of complex conjugate, right? Or the conjugate of complex number.